Hello, dear Akans. How are you all? Are you all ready for today's class? Right. Just tell me, what did we learn in the last week? Correct. We learned prepositions, right? We did a few exercises also on prepositions. We found out where the apple was using prepositions. We could tell the position of the apple using prepositions, right? And also, we could frame a few sentences using prepositions by looking at a picture, right? Like this. Looking at this picture, we framed a few sentences like this. And also, even before this also, you have been framing sentences, right? Looking at this picture also, you framed sentences like this. And looking at this picture also, you framed sentences like this. And there are a few other pictures also. Looking at them, you could frame sentences. So you know how to frame sentences looking at a picture. Right? Okay, let us just discuss the same thing today. Let us take the same picture, this one only, and you know how to frame sentences looking at a picture. How are we doing all these days? So for that, what did we do? We just look at the picture. We see what the picture is about, right? We see, what do we see in the picture? We see what are all the things that are there in the picture. We also see who are all the people that are there in the picture, right? And we also see what is actually happening in the picture and who is doing what, right? We see all these things and then we frame sentences, correct? So if we see this picture, I see a park in the picture, right? I see a few children playing in the park. There is a boy who is playing football. There is a boy behind the tree. A girl is doing skipping. Two boys are on seesaw. There is a big tree in the park. There are two big trees outside the park, right? There is a small boy in the park in the picture. He's holding a ball in the hand and there are a few toys beside him, right? So by seeing the picture, we are framing sentences. By seeing what are all the things, who are all the people, you know, what are they doing actually? So I see and then we are able to frame sentences like this. Read this. I see a park in the picture. There are six boys and a girl playing in the park. If you want to write it clearly, you can, instead of saying children, you can write even like this. There are six boys and a girl, like that. Two boys are on the seesaw. A girl is skipping. There is a big tree in the park and two trees outside the park. If you want, you can add, you know, more sentences to this. Like, you know, there is a small boy here. He's holding a ball in his hand. There is a boy behind the tree. All these things you can add. So all these are the sentences we framed using, you know, by seeing the picture. You know, what are we learning today? We are going to learn to frame sentences using a guideline called I see, I think. What is the guideline? I see, I think. So let us just see how to write. So let us take the same picture again. So all these are the sentences that we could frame using I see. Now let us try to frame a few more sentences using I think. Right? Okay, now how to frame sentences using I think? You know, even for this, we should look at the picture critically, carefully. You know, we should also think about the timing of the picture, you know, or we can look at the facial expressions of different people. What are they thinking, right? And also we can, you know, what is the event? What is the thing overall is happening in the picture? So all these things we should think and we should put our thoughts in the form of sentences. That's it. So for example, if we are going to frame a few sentences using I think for this picture, let us see. What do I think? I will tell you. You listen and understand, okay? I think it is evening. By looking at this picture, I think it is evening. But nowhere in the picture it is written that it is evening. There is no clock, okay? The sky is still clear, right? It is bright. The picture is bright. So I think it is still evening. You know what my friend thinks looking at this picture? She said that she thinks it is Saturday morning. Right? It can be Sunday morning also. It can be Saturday evening, Sunday evening. So it is all our thoughts. Thoughts can be same or different. I think in a way, and you may think it in a different way. Some other person can think it in a different way. Thoughts can be same or different. I think it is evening. What do you think? Do you think it is Saturday morning? It can happen, right? It also can be the case. So, and I also think, looking at this boy as he is standing just beside this girl, okay, I think he is waiting for his turn to do skipping. You know what my friend is thinking? She said that she thinks this boy is counting the number of skips that she is doing. So she thinks that he is counting the skips. I think that he is waiting for his turn. There is no question of right and wrong, right? They are all our thoughts. And I also think, as there are no adults in the picture, I think all these children, they stay just next to the park. They stay very near to the park. So that is why they might have come by themselves to the park. So that is why I think they stay very near to the park, maybe just next to the park. But you know what my friend said? She thinks that this park is there inside their apartment compound. That also can happen, right? A few apartment compounds, they have parks also inside the compound. So she thinks that this park is inside the apartment compound. That is why children, they come alone and they go alone. So that is why her thought is that, and my thought is they stay just next to the park. Thoughts can be same or different, but when it comes to seeing, so whoever sees it, even if I look at this picture, you look at this picture, or my friend looks at this picture, we all see the same things, but we think differently. Right? So when we frame sentences for I think, see, I think it is evening. I think the boy is waiting for his turn, this boy. And I think the children stay nearby as I don't see any adults in the picture. Right? And what my friend is thinking? She thinks it is a weekend. And she thinks he is counting the skips that she is doing. And she thinks the park is inside the apartment compound. Right? It can be anything. And now you think, what do you think about this picture? Correct? Okay, now let us look at another picture also. Let us exercise on the other picture also. But before we go, let us think, what is the use of framing sentences using I think? Anyway, we know how to frame sentences using I see. Right? And what is the use of framing sentences using I think also? You know, it will develop your critical thinking skills. Because if you have to frame sentences using I think, you should really observe the picture critically, carefully. So it will develop your critical thinking skills. And also, you know, if you do like this, it is like an opportunity for you to give your interpretation of the picture, your understanding of the picture. Right? You will get such opportunity. And also, you know, in future, you will start writing paragraphs. So if you write a paragraph using I see, I think guideline, it will give a structure to your paragraph. There are all these uses of, you know, writing sentences using I see, I think. Right. Now let us go to the next picture. Picture 2. Now I'm giving you 30 seconds time. Just think, what do you see in the picture? All right, so what do you see? Tell me. I see a bus in the picture, but I think it is a school bus because there are students in the bus. And I also see a few students are talking happily, a few students are playing, a few of them are simply sitting, a few of them look tired. If you look at this boy, see, they look tired and they are sleeping. What else do you see? I see a man in the picture blowing whistle, right? Correct. And I also see a girl here who is, you know, laughing out loudly, it seems, and she's trying to talk to the man. I see a girl here who is playing with bubbles. There are bubbles all over here. Right? All these things I see in the picture. I also see this girl holding a balloon. This boy is with a mask. And this boy is having hand fan. Right? She is having bubbles. So a few children have toys in their hands. Now let us try to frame sentences for I think. What do you think is the picture about? What must be the event? Or you know, what is the timing? What might be the timing of the event? Look at the expressions of the children. What do you think they are doing? Right. So when you think of the sentences using I think they are not, you know, there is no school for them that day because I do not see any bags, school bags in the picture. And I also see, as there are a few toys in their hands, what do you think? Are they going somewhere? Are they returning from somewhere? What do you think? You think, I'm not going to tell. And I think this man is the attender in the bus. And he's blowing the whistle, but why? Why do you think he is blowing the whistle? I think he is trying to control the children. Because do you see, there is a lot of noise, it seems. Children are talking, playing, you know, making noise. So this man is trying to control the children by blowing whistle. Right? So what else do you think looking at this picture? You think, keep thinking. Okay, so let us discuss today's learning engagement. It is okay, these are all the possible sentences that we can make looking at this picture. If you want, you can add more when you really write in the journal. I see a bus in the picture. I think it is school bus. There are many students wearing uniform. I think they are grade 1 students. Yes, looking at their height and all, I think they are grade 1 students, but nowhere in the picture it is written that grade 1 students, right? Do you see any board here, grade 1 students? No, it is only our thinking. I think they are grade 1 students. Few of them are talking, few are sleeping, few are playing, few are just sitting. I see a man in the bus blowing whistle. I think he is the attender in the bus. I think he is trying to control the children. And what else do you think? Fill in the blank. You keep thinking about this picture and then write your sentences. So your learning engagement for today is, look at this picture carefully. Picture 2 is this one only. And write all these sentences. But before writing, do not just copy the sentences as they are. Before you write, observe the picture. Read each and every line. Relate the sentences with the picture. Understand what is written. And then you write in the journal. Right? For that, write this heading. Looking at the picture, I can frame and write few sentences using the guideline. I see, I think. I will also follow punctuation, which is very important. Right, now the next learning engagement is, you know, right? Every week we are learning 5 vocabulary words, new vocabulary. Last week, if you remember, we learnt only 4 because we thought those were the difficult spellings. So this week we have given you 6. So 4 plus 6, 10. So write the below new vocabulary in your English journal in vocabulary partition. If you observe, what are all these words? Between, behind, beside, in front of, above, and below. Correct? All these are prepositions. So that is the learning engagement for today. So remember, the use of framing sentences using I see and I think are, it will develop your critical thinking skills. It will give a structure to your paragraph. And it, if you do like this, you will be able to express your interpretation, your understanding of a picture. Right? So try to follow this. So whenever you look at any picture, not just the things that are there in the picture, also think, what is the event, you know, what are your thoughts on the picture, think about all of them. That's it, students. Till we meet in the next class. Ta-ta, bye-bye, see you, happy learning.